In the den, the new dragon has pledged to invest her own money in the very best business ideas. When Simon Booth, along with his daughter Ruby, asked for £75,000 for his wooden balance bike company, was she prepared to part with her cash?
Balance bikes are the perfect way to start children onto cycling. Customers include John Lewis, and have just placed their first order, £35,000 worth.
I particularly loved it that he brought little Ruby on to demonstrate it. She's gorgeous. I fell in love with her, actually. And I thought the product was fantastic.
Having revealed his latest turnover of nearly £500,000, made just 30 grand net profit, Deborah Meaden pushed Simon for an explanation.
What's your overheads?
Okay, key overheads will be exhibitions.
Do you want to put some numbers against those exhibitions? How much you spend on exhibitions?
Exhibitions is in the region of 45,000 to 50,000.
Okay, and wages and salaries?
I think 45,000.
Okay, and then what about your rent?
It's about 15,000, I guess.
Okay, so at the moment you've managed to explain 100,000 to me.
Right. Deborah started really drilling down into the numbers, and fair enough, it was quite a substantial gap in the spending. But by this time, I really had gone completely blank. I must apologise, I can't pull those figures out of
that. Oh, you need to. Do you know how important this is?
Sure.
Simon, I'm really sorry. I'm out.
Quickly after Deborah had declared herself out, Peter was out, and then Theo was out as well. I almost thought, right, how can I get out of here without anyone noticing?
But thankfully for Simon, there was a logistics expert who had yet to declare her hand.
Simon, you say the actual costing you £20.
Yes.
To make. Is that shipped?
We've got some shipping costs in there as well,
right.
But
straight away I picked up he'd not included shipping costs in his figures, so that gave me a bit of a glimmer of hope, because I thought, well, if he's shipping from England, then there's a cheaper way of doing this. What about your distribution costs in the UK?
Coming from our warehouse to the customer, that has to be included in the overhead as well.
Right.
So, yeah, so there is
that I would think would easily account for at least £40,000.
Yeah.
Hilary's discoveries certainly changed the mood in the den.
I quite like it, in actual fact. And so because I like the product so much, I'm going to make you an offer. Half the money, that's £37,500, for 15%.
I also think it's a good product and I can see mileage in it. So I would like to offer you half the money for 15%. I don't think I'd have invested on my own, because I think it really needed quite a lot of work. And I thought that if I was investing with Duncan, then we'd share the workload with it.
But what I'd like to do is accept your offer.
Well done, Simon. Very good move.
I came out there with a result. Ruby was one of the first people that I told, and she was like, yay, well done, Daddy.
After his success in the den,
hello.
Morning.
Simon headed back to his offices in Somerset. 6 months later, how is the business getting on?
Since the den, taking on three extra people, the phones just never, ever stop ringing.
In fact, Simon says this year he'll turn over £1 million and can already forecast £2 million for 2012.
I just feel like we're completely bucking all the trends. We're at Motorcycle Live, which is like the premium motorcycle event of the year. So this is a consumer event. They're the ones with the cash, and we're trying to capture that cash. Thank you very much. And a show like this, we'd expect it to return at least 150,000 to 200,000.
But Simon's success has come without the backing of his two dragons. The rigorous process of due diligence that happens before each deal is signed had uncovered another shareholder that hadn't been mentioned in the den.
That, quite honestly, was something that was right back in from the early days of the business, and I'd almost forgotten about it.
Simon had neglected to rescind those shares. Both Duncan and I decided that neither of us were prepared to work with a silent shareholder.
Having not gone ahead with the deal with the Dragons, I'm really excited of going out on my own. I see that we've got massive potential, and I do feel that I've got the strengths to actually make it happen.
I'm sure he'll succeed, actually. He's a lovely guy, and he's got a lovely little daughter, so I think he'll do very well.